नमस्ते मैम, वेलकम डॉक्टर अर्चना बोगना। प्रणाम
नमस्ते टू
मैम।
एवरीबॉडी, नाइस मीटिंग ऑल ऑफ यू।
नमस्ते मैम, कैसे
नमस्ते
हो
मीना
आप?
जी, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल।
मैम, ये हमारी टीम है डॉक्टर सतीश फ्रॉम फार्मा स्टेट एकेडमी, जो हमारे साथ होस्ट कर रहे हैं इवेंट को। और अभी डॉक्टर मोना ने आपको विश किया, शी इज माई वाइफ कलीग। एंड विवेक सर हमारे बीच हैं, जो कि इंडस्ट्री के एक्सपर्ट के तौर पे हैं साथ आपके साथ ही। और माय प्रोजेक्ट एसोसिएट डॉक्टर लोकेश अधिकारी एंड मैनी मोर आर गोइंग थ्रू, यू नो, दीज आर द प्राइम मेंबर्स, यू कैन से पिलर्स ऑफ द इवेंट। एंड सून आवर पब्लिशिंग टीम इज गोइंग आल्सो गोइंग टू जॉइन अस।
ओके, सो सर, हाय मैम, गुड इवनिंग। एंड वी आर लाइव ऑन फेसबुक, लिंक्डइन एंड यूट्यूब अलोंग विद द ज़ूम। So we welcome all the participants
yes.
who have joined to these channels. I am admitting all the candidates in participants in waiting. Wait. Yeah. Good evening, everyone. We're just starting in a few moments.
Very good evening to all the learners who have joined us today, all the guests who have joined us today. This is Swati from Pharma State Academy, and we are looking forward to hosting you today on this book launch event. We'll start in a minute, just waiting for everyone's connections to stabilize. I hope everyone is able to hear us and see us. Thank you for giving us this opportunity to host you today. And first of all, before starting the event today, a very happy World Pharmacists Day to all of you here. We really salute the hard work that you do, the daily toil that you go through to make, to create medicines, to formulate medicines which save lives. And that is one of the most important duties of any human on this earth. You have to give in with all your heart and hard work. And thank you for doing that day in and day out for all of us here. Happy World Pharmacists Day to all of you. Let us start. Yes, Satish, can we have... Thank you, Satish, and thank you all of the participants who have joined us on time, before time, and now who will be joining us also. So today we meet again to launch the book and wish you all a happy Pharmacist Day also. We are today launching the book Industrial Pharmacy 1 in English, in Hindi, and a guide also, an expert review guide on industrial pharmacy, written by Dr. Ajay Simelti. And today we will have a lot of guest speakers also who would be briefing you about what all industrial pharmacy is and what you will get in this book, that also we are looking forward to hear from Dr. Ajay Simelty. Today, we will be hosting our chief patron, Professor Annapurna Nautiyal, our patron, Professor J.B. Nadda, Professor P.K. Sahu, guest of honor from academia, Dr. Archana Bahuguna, guest of honor from industry, and Mr. Vivek Hatangari, guest of honor from industry, along with Dr. Mona Simelty and Dr. Ajim Simelty. So let me first of all, as a formality, tell you a bit about Dr. Ajay. Most of us here know about him, the exemplary work that he has done for the society, for the academia, and he continues doing so with all his hard work. He is Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, HNB Garhwal University, University Swayam Coordinator also. He is listed in world's top 2% scientist of pharmacy and pharmacology by Stanford University Research 2020. He has to his name an international award awarded DICO Foundation Postdoctoral Research Fellowship and invited by Meijo University, Nagoya, Japan as visiting scientist for research for the year 2011-12. He is also an expert reviewer at Iceland Research Foundation, Israel Science Foundation, and Scientific Expert Reprise for Ministry of Institution and University Research, Italy, also with DST, Government of India. He is a peer reviewer at Elsevier Books, US. Apart from this, he is also an editorial board member of various national and international reputed journals, also a peer reviewer for various national and international journals of repute. He has to his name 11 funded research projects. If I talk about the publications, they're immense, 81 papers, 74 scientific abstracts, 2 chapters, 11 books to his name. These 3 books adding to his profile now, and has to his name 3 patents, 1 Indian patent granted, 1 published and 1 filed. His immense work can be seen in the e-content development that he has done. He has done almost of more than 200 hours for Swayam, for Arpit courses, for Swayam Prabha modules, and also for PharmaState Academy. His one of the MOOCs academic writing was ranked number 1 MOOC of country and ranked in top 30 MOOCs worldwide. He's one of the most cited researchers with an edge index of 26, more than 2000 citations, and a total impact of greater than 90. This is all I can manage in this short time. There is a lot to tell about him, but still I will welcome Dr. Ajay to first of all address the listeners who have gathered here today. Over to you, Dr. Ajay.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Swati, Dr. Satish from Beckham. The backing support always from the PharmaState Academy and the entire team. First of all, I warmly welcome all the guests of honor, our chief patron, our patron, and all the dear participants, learners, teachers, researchers, students. We welcome you all on the World Pharmacist Day 2021, marking the importance of pharmacists in the healthcare. The person who can be trusted for the healthcare, the link between the medicals and the patients, the vital link. So with this, on this holy occasion, which is devoted to the pharmacist's hard work, I warmly welcome all of you on today's event. As far as our guest of honors are concerned, obviously, our chief patron, Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Annapurna Nautiyal, maybe She hasn't joined so far, but yes, if she could able to connect us, so we will hear us, we will hear her also. She is a well-known geopolitical academic figure, geopolitical scientist, the academician, and the first lady vice chancellor of the HNB Gadwal Central University. So, as far as the pattern is concerned, Professor J.B. Nadda, who is the director of CEC, due to some reasons, he is not available to us, but he has extended his warm wishes and congratulations to our team. We always get his unconditional support in any of the situations. As you know, the National Coordinator Consortium for Educational Communication is the one of the National Coordinator of SWAYAM, which is Government of India's platform of online courses, massive open online courses, MOOCs. And our course, Industrial Pharmacy, have been the result of the support by the CEC New Delhi. Then Professor P.K. Sahu, I warmly welcome. He's just going to join us. He's the director of DIPSAR, Delhi Institute of Pharmaceutical Science and Research, the only university, the only pharma university, first university on pharma, you can say, Delhi Pharmaceutical Science Research University, senior most professor of the university, a good academician, and a humble and a noble teacher. As an academic expert, Dr. Archana Bahugna, who is a well-known scientist and industry expert, has a lot of credits to her CV. And we are very happy. We are very lucky that we are getting the chance to hear her today. Welcome, ma'am. We warmly welcome your presence, your gracious presence to this event. And Vivek, sir, thanks a lot for blessing us for the event. He's the well-known educator, motivational speaker, as I have heard him, and a very approaching man of words, and you will hear him yourself. His words are his introduction itself, himself. So welcome, Vivek, sir. Along with that, in this series, we have with us the team EMRC, Educational Multimedia Resource Center of Government of India, of Roorkee Center, where we have produced our complete online course. We are thankful to, first of all, the director, Dr. Rajkumar Bharadwaj, due to some medical reasons and is in problems in family, he is unable to join us, but he has also extended his wishes to the entire team and for the event. We are missing Bharadwaj, sir. For representing EMRC, we have with us Dr. Rakshak Jain, senior producer, EMRC, and his entire team of Educational Multimedia Resource Center, Roorkee. Dr. Shruti, Rama, Jitin, Anurag, Pushpam, Ali, and all the members. Welcome all, and our publishing team, Anil sir, Nikunj, Naresh ji, Rakshak sir has come. Welcome, Rakshak sir. So this is the team which are welcoming you on our event, and we are very happy to share our hard work with you in next 2 hours, you can say maximum up to 7:30. We'll be finishing our event. we'll be putting the rationale of coming up with this work and the live interaction with our learners with the academic and industry appeal. So thank you for being with us, and we will be discussing the things with with respect to the industrial pharmacy, because academic industry interaction is utmost important for increasing the employability of graduates. That is the core aspect of national education policy. We felt that there must be some pragmatic approach for taking up the syllabi, the graduate syllabi or pharmacy graduate syllabi, so that it becomes up to the standard of the needs of the industry. So with this note, I think my team, Mukesh, please check if Dr. Sahu has come up. If Dr. Sahu may, where is the time actually? So what,
sir, we are waiting.
Okay, no issue. Whenever the Sahu sir comes, please let us know.
Yes,
and,
sure, sir.
Meanwhile, Dr. Swati, we can move ahead.
Yes, Dr. Ajay. So first of all, please tell us about the books, Dr. Ajay, so that after this, we will do the official book launch. What are these books about? Why did you choose to launch a Hindi version also? So there are questions around these. Please tell us about
Dr. Swati, of course. This is not like that there are no books. There are very, very wonderful books. You know, but the demand of the school, the demand of the industry, and the learning capability and cognitive behavior of students, that must be matched. That mapping must be there. What I thought, that the industry expectations obviously are very high. Okay, but first time when the student is learning about the dosage form or the things, and learning the things with respect to the industrial needs, we have to take the student from scratch and groom it and take it to the industry level. So we will have to be very consistent in our efforts. What is the problem that whenever the student is for the very first time touching up the concept of industrial production and all that, the basic concept must be clear. Even we say, for example, when we explain pre-formulation in our book or in our course, we explain with this simple thing so that we can, because Dr. Archana knows, she's a chemist. She knows that what we are, say, polymorphism. If I start with the polymorphism directly with the forms and all that, so we started with the story of the Napoleon Bonaparte, that yes, what happened with the Napoleon Bonaparte, how the colors of their buttons turned gray or dirty gray. They were thinking that it's a wrath of God, but actually it was not. It was just a conversion of one polymorphic form into another polymorphic form. This is the storytelling which student needs. And then taking into their brains, actually it is the delivery of the things that which a teacher can do. I think my industry expert know better than me. I agree, but I know my student better than them. Okay, so I know them how to communicate my idea to their level. So just we thought, we prepared the course in that note, that online course on the Swayam platform, which had been the success for the last three events. We have received more than 11,500 learners across several countries from pharmacy specifically. So we thought that let's take this in the form of book, and that's why we have come up with this in this book form.
Okay, so we have three books, Dr. Ajay. Let me make it very simple for our audience. We have Industrial Pharmacy 1, which is launched in English. Then you have again this book launched in Hindi. Iska Hindi version ab available hai. Aur third one is Quick Review on Industrial Pharmacy 1. All three books are simultaneously being launched in this event. Why one, Dr. Ajay? Why one? Are we expecting more now?
Actually, I was working on this project, Dr. Archana, Dr. Vivek sir. I was working on the concept for the last 3 years maybe, but to the setback in my family with the demise of my mother, I couldn't come up with the books earlier. So that's why I have dedicated this entire work to my mother, my late mother. You know, what I think that when the students are preparing not only for the text, but also for the competitive exam like GPAT and all that, what is required that they know the things in depth. So we came up with a textbook, Industrial Pharmacy First in English. And to revise it quickly with respect to the exam point of view, we came up with a quick review so that we can have quick notes, FAQs, MCQs, glossaries all put together so that if someone has done other things, someone has grasped all the basic concept, he or she, the student want to, you know, just revise it in few hours, then the second book, quick review. And the third book dedicated to our Matribhasha, Meri Matribhasha, Hindi or Hindi Bhashi, Unhi Sabhi Chhatra Chhatraon Ko Samarpit. जिनके लिए केवल समझना इंपॉर्टेंट होता है, एक बार वो समझ जाए तो लैंग्वेज बैरियर सब खत्म हो जाए। कंसेप्ट को जानना ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है बजाय इंग्लिश में अपने पांडित्य का होना। और मेरे बहुत सारे छात्र छात्रा इसी चीज में सहमे डरे सहमे रह जाते हैं इंग्लिश को देख के, यार हमारा क्या होगा, जबकि वो जब वो करने लगते हैं, सीखने लगते हैं, जो पेश करने लगते हैं, केवल लैंग्वेज बैरियर के कारण वो पीछे रहने लगते हैं। तो मुझे लगा व्हाई नॉट टू कम अप विद द हिंदी बुक दैट टू इन इंग्लिश, जिसमें कि हमारे टेक्निकल टर्म्स इंग्लिश में हैं, सारी चीजें टर्म्स में होगा, और इसलिए मुझको उसमें मेहनत ज्यादा लगी इंग्लिश बुक से ज्यादा, कि क्यों ना उस चीज को लेके आया जाए। और मुझे लगता है अब हिंदी भाषी मेरा जो छात्र है, छात्राएं हैं, जो हमारी जो नीड है वो हम पूरी करके लेके आ रहे हैं। उसके बाद वो बच्चा क्विक रिव्यू पढ़ता है तो वो सारा चीज पैकअप कर लेगा। तो दैट इज अ कंप्लीट पैकेज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू इंडस्ट्रियल फार्मेसी। और ये मैंने इसलिए सब्जेक्ट चुना बिकॉज इट इज द फर्स्ट एंड लास्ट टाइम द फार्मेसी ग्रेजुएट is going to study the tablet and tablet manufacturing or any other dosage form manufacturing. So what happens if he or she studies just for sake of passing the paper? That cost has to be borne by the industry because he is going to fail the many batches. Okay, and so I thought that this thing must be worked out properly and very serious. This is the reason why we have come up with the package of three books.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay, because this seems to be the need of the hour. Pharmacy is now picking up speed, especially after COVID. We saw a lot of things happening in industry also. So academia has to back this up. If industry needs more, academia has to do more. You are creating students and Dr. Ajay is doing an awesome work here. Kudos to you, Dr. Ajay. So आपने ये बुक लॉन्च किया डॉक्टर अजय, तो हम ये तीन तो पढ़ लेंगे, बट इसके नेक्स्ट क्या आने वाला है और क्या कवर कर रहे हैं आप इंडस्ट्रियल फार्मेसी वन में?
इंडस्ट्रियल फार्मेसी वन में जैसा कि हेलो की सिलेबस ओरिएंटेड बुक है, पर इट इज द नीड ऑफ द आवर फॉर द स्पेशली फॉर द ऑल द लर्नर जो कि सिंपल बीएससी बेस से आ रहे हैं और वो फार्मा इंडस्ट्री में जाना चाहते हैं, तो एटलीस्ट उनके लिए प्राइमर के तौर पे भी ये चीज बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि दे लर्न द थिंग्स अबाउट द डोसेज फॉर्म एंड ऑल दैट व्हिच दे हैवंट स्टडीड एट ऑल. Okay, so all the dosage forms, solid, liquid, and gas, like propellants and all that, they all have been covered in the 40 chapters there. And strictly as per the PCI syllabi, we have covered the things, all the syllabi, and only a few books are there in the national scenario or the international scenario which are covering the syllabi in that much depth or that much totality. We might not have gone to that much depth, which the reference books are going for the or encyclopedias are going, but on need to know basis, utmost need to know basis, what is required, and need to know basis, what is required, is covered in quick review or in industry pharmacy first. And very soon we are going to come up with another work, and rather we are there on art of writing and publishing in pharmaceutical journals, which is also going to be released very soon. We hope that our pharmacy students will come up with a good research and contribute to the society. And this, I think this is my small work for the, not only for the pharmacy profession, but also to the catering the need of the society. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay. And again and again, we are receiving messages about Happy World Pharmacists Day. So three cheers to all the pharmacists today who have joined again. Right. I just said, let us move forward and do the official book launch. Satish, can we have the video? Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. And thank you for the launch. Congratulations, Dr. Ajay, Dr. Mona, for this wonderful, writing this wonderful doing book and doing great, going to great hikes and hard work, where you are creating courses, you are writing books. That is awesome. And very aptly named RX Perth series. Wonderful thought behind this. Right. So do we have PK Sahu sir now in the meeting?
We'll see. We will, our team will let you know.
Sure. So let us move to the expert comments by the guest we have today, and who have joined us currently. Let me invite Dr. Archana Bahuguna for her expert comments. But before letting her speak, let me introduce her. I'll not take much time, but her work is exemplary. And I must make aware about her work and then welcome her. So Dr. Archana Bahuguna, she is a pharmaceutical industry professional with over 20 years of experience of working in leadership roles in Indian and multinational pharmaceutical companies such as Unichem, Zydus Cadila, Merck, Pfizer, Acutest, KPMG, and Reptacos Brit. She has extensive global experience in technical leadership of analytical research and development and quality control function, especially NCEs and generics, supporting development programs from phase 1 to phase 3 for drug substances, drug products comprising oral solids, liquid orals, ointments and gels, large volume parenterals also. She has successfully led several regulatory inspections, a very, very important thing in pharmaceutical industry, in her professional assignments as an analytical and quality control SME with regulators like USFDA, EMA, PICS, ANVISA, and regulators from Tanzania, Ethiopia, Uganda, Kenya, Malawi, and WHO India. Her academics are educational background. She is a PhD in pharmaceutical analysis from University of Mumbai and has obtained her master's degree in organic chemistry from University of Mumbai and is a university gold medalist. You will know about her recognition and awards after I speak about her academic affiliations. She is associated with academia, is contributing profusely there. She is visiting faculty at SIES Institute of Chromatography and Spectroscopy at Navi Mumbai. She is also a life member of Chromatographic Society of India and actively involved as a speaker. She is a member on Board of Studies, Department of Chemistry, SIES College, Mumbai. Also an industry guide for Master of Pharmacy program in Pharmaceutical Analysis and Quality Assurance at Narsi Monjee Institute of Management Studies, Mumbai. 6 students have successfully completed their M.Pharm research projects under her guidance. There's a list of recognition and awards, which I'm not going to tell each one of them, but few literally stand out. And that is why I'm going to take those names. She has been a recipient of numerous awards and scholarships during her academics and professional career. The most recent one being, she is recognized as Asia GCC Iconic Woman Leader Award in September 2021 in the field of pharmaceutical quality control. And the second one that takes the cake is Dr. K. Hamid's Chemistry Prize for the year 1995 from University of Bombay for securing highest number of marks in the subject of organic chemistry at the MSc degree exam held in May 1995. There's a lot that I am not reading out, but you must have heard what an exemplary work in the field of pharma. So here I welcome Dr. Archana Bahuguna. Happy Pharmacist Day, ma'am.
Thank you, Swati. A very happy Pharmacist Day to all the participants in today's session and to all professionals who are working across the globe in pharmaceutical industry. The theme of this year's World Pharmacist Day is pharmacy, always trusted for good health. And this is something which we have realized, not better than as we have realized in the past year and a half. So first and foremost, I would like to thank Dr. Semaldi for inviting me for this book launch. I'm also thankful to the university and its faculty for organizing this event on World Pharmacist Day. It's a very significant day today. And I feel very extremely humbled, privileged, and honored to be associated with HNB Garhwal University. Not because just I am from the pharmaceutical industry, but also because it takes me back to my origins in the state of Uttarakhand. The late founder, Shri H.N. Bhagunaji, who has left behind a legacy for students, not only from the Hill State, but also Pan India. And I feel very blessed because some journeys take you back to your origins. And this one today takes me back to the small hamlet of Bhugani in Uttarakhand, very close to Srinagar, you know, where my ancestors, my forefathers, and the founder of the university were neighbors. So that's something very interesting. So talking about what industry expects from pharmacy graduates. Now, I had the opportunity to go through the preface of the book that has been launched today, and courteous congratulations to you, Dr. Samaldi, for bringing out such an excellent book. And how this is different, I have not gone through the details, so it will be very difficult for me to see how it is different, but what I can visualize from the preface is that it has an excellent compilation of almost all kind of dosage forms, the QC testing required for this dosage form, and this also includes the packaging materials which are used in the industry. And apart from this, in the beginning, in the first few chapters, I see a very good description of pre-formulation studies, pH solubility studies, the very basic concepts, you know, which guide formulation development in the industry. So I think it's an excellent book which will kind of, you know, bridge the gap between industry and the academic curriculum that universities are offering. And Dr. Samaldi was talking about language. So in the industry, when we interview freshers for various roles, so we don't pay much focus on how good of an English you speak, what is your accent, what kind of flowery words you use, because our aim is to see whether the person understands the science and the basics behind it. Because once a person joins the industry, there's no time to sit and train a person on the basic aspects. So it is expected that the person understands the basic aspects, and furthermore, it can always be built up. So language is not a barrier anymore. The world is getting global now. Talking about the expectations, well, the pharmaceutical industry, as we see, is an amalgamation of extensive teamwork across professionals, from process chemistry, you will have process chemistry experts, you will have formulators, you will have analytical scientists, statisticians, clinical experts, toxicologists, regulatory and compliance professionals who get together. It's a huge task of bringing a molecule into the market, and it's an effort of hard work of huge teams over a period of years to bring a molecule, you know, which is safe and efficacious for human consumptions by patients. Now, COVID-19 has changed not only the lives of each one of us across the globe, but it has also changed the businesses. And the first one to be impacted is the pharmaceutical industry. So the pharmaceutical industry, as we see, it's kind of a mission critical industry. And they are the frontline workers, you know, who are not visible when there is a lockdown. They are not visible, but these are the people who are working across world, across various locations, risking their lives to ensure that there is no shortage of essential medicines in the supply chain. And that is how we have seen in less than a year, vaccines are now available for COVID-19, novel coronavirus. And a lot of my colleagues, a lot of my co-workers have lost their lives in the past year and a half to COVID-19. And I think this is the right occasion to dedicate this event and this book launch to the lives of professionals who lost their lives due to COVID-19 pandemic, who are part of the industry. And mind you, there have been my team members who have been very young, who've left behind their families. So this leads to the first requirement of working in the industry is dedication. So whether you like it or not, it's a dedication. It's not just about knowledge or science, but I think one must have a passion. One must have a passion for making a difference to lives of millions of patients across the globe. So working in the industry is not a 9-to-5 routine, glamorous job wherein you punch at 9 o'clock and you punch and leave at 5 o'clock. There are no timings when you're working in pharma because everything is urgent and there is no tomorrow. So what is important is that a person must have a passion for science or for whatever area in the industry he or she is working, because only when you have passion, you will have dedication and interest. So that is something which is very important. Second thing is that these are medicines are something which are meant for consumption by patients. And these products are a result of years of extensive clinical trials, experiments in the lab. And hence, it's very, very important that the professionals who are involved in developing, manufacturing, testing, and releasing these products, they have highest levels of ethics, integrity, honesty, and ownership. That is something which is not taught in any university or in any college, but I think that is a basic essential quality that in the industry we are looking out for individuals, because nobody is going to be standing on your head 24/7 every day to do a policing job, you know, whether what experiments you have done, have they been done properly, what is the outcome. And as we know, experiments can have positive outcome, they can have negative outcomes. So it is very important to also to understand the negative outcomes and the reasons for those negative outcomes. And that is where it's very important when batches fail, when quality issues pop up, to kind of honestly admit and investigate the issues rather than keeping things under cover and creating problems for all. Another thing which has changed in the past 1 year is the way in which the industry operates. Of course, in India, our focus is mainly on generics, but because of the novel coronavirus pandemic, now the shift is towards novel therapeutic targets for unmet medical needs. And the focus is more on biologicals, on medical devices, on orally inhaled nasal drug products, and on polymeric formulation, complex polymeric formulations. And the Western world is already started working on it. And it's high time that we start working on such kind of products, even in the Indian markets. And for that, we need to have universities which cater to education in these aspects, because primarily we are a very good generic market. So that is one segment where the industry is headed towards. Another change that we see is towards, we call it Pharma 4.0 in the industry. And what is Pharma 4.0? Pharma 4.0 is nothing but introducing more of artificial intelligence, IoT, Internet of Things, cobots, and digitalizing pharmaceutical operations, especially in the manufacturing arena. And for that, it is also very important to have an understanding of the way digital concepts work in the industry today. That's another very important segment where the industry is moving towards. And the aim is to minimize manual intervention, to ensure that there are less failures, the product quality is consistent, and robots or cobots don't take leaves and weekly offs. So continuous manufacturing can be achieved, and thereby medications can be made available to patients irrespective of the lockdown or the pandemic conditions. So the industry is gearing up for devising systems and procedures to ensure that in the future, despite pandemics, there would be a situation where the drug supply chains are not impacted. And that's something which needs to be done. And when you join the industry, definitely your degree or your basic qualification helps you. But subsequently, it is also very important to keep the student within you alive all through your journey in the pharmaceutical industry. And for that, you have to constantly keep undergoing training programs. You have to constantly keep on self-educating yourself. So once you join the pharmaceutical industry, nobody is going to hold your hand and take you to a classroom to teach. So you have to have that kind of an initiative of keeping abreast with the latest technologies, with the latest developments in your field of interest, in the field which you are working, and also to adopt them as and when required. And last but not the least, what is equally more important is to develop products in accordance with the regulations. So in the industry, you see, every region, every country has its own national regulating authority, and you have different clauses or different laws which come under the concept of good manufacturing practices. And pharmaceutical products need to be developed, manufactured, tested, and released as per these good manufacturing practices. And subsequent to this, the facilities are inspected by the regulatory agencies and approvals are provided. So it is also very important to have a very good understanding of the regulations and of these good manufacturing practices. And since India is the one of the major exporters of generic products to rest of the world, to all countries across the globe, so it is very, very important for us working in the Indian segment to understand what are the US requirements, what are the Latin American requirements, what are the European requirements. And same thing applies for EMEA, that's Europe, Middle East, Africa, and of course Asia Pacific. So that's something I think which is very unique. When you work in the Indian pharma, you get an exposure to all kinds of markets, you know, which doesn't happen perhaps if you're working for the US or EU. So that puts additional onus on each one of us to understand these requirements and to get well-versed with these requirements when we are working in our laboratories and in manufacturing facilities. So that's also very, very important. And last but not the least, one thing that I would say, like to say, is that there would be pressures. It's an industry where there are pressures every day on every individual. So take it lightly. Don't get stressed out, because I see a lot of colleagues, they get a lot of stressed out or burnt out because of pressures. So when you work in pharma, first you need to take care of yourselves, of your health and of your mental and physical well-being, and then kind of work for you know, the rest of the mankind. So that's something which is very, very important. So that's all from my side, and thank you so much for having me over here, and thank you for the attention.
Thank you so much, Dr. Rachna, for the kind words. Rather, you gave a very, very important, you touched upon a very, very important point. First of all, you have to keep take care of the health of yours. Being a health worker, being a frontline worker, you have to take care of your health. Then you have to be a very, very hardworking and a person with a lot of integrity, because you are creating, you are preparing drugs, you are preparing medicines which are going to save lives. So the loopholes that we do in experiments while we were studying, those have no space in the industry. Those have they should not be done here. And that is why you need to read books, you need to network with the right people, and create a better mindset to take this industry forward. We are the pharmacy of the world. India is the pharmacy of the world. People across the world look up to India to provide even the vaccines and all the medicines that if you are aware about this industry. A lot of big companies export drugs to US and all, and there's no margin of error. There is a Six Sigma thing coming in, and there's no margin of error. So it's better to prepare the base very, very strong. The foundation should be strong. And Dr. Raja, your books have to provide some foundation at least. So thank you for writing the books. And thank you, Dr. Rachna, for a wonderful, wonderful talk today from your side. Please stay with us.
Thank you, Dr. Rachna. I think we will be happy to have you for a little bit more talks and more time, so that some queries related to I was seeing on the chat box related to the industry and all that. If you can spare some few more minutes, then we would be very highly obliged.
Sure, I'll be good.
Thank you, Doctor. So I think Swati, Dr. Professor Sahu sir has joined us. I think we should invite him if he's there. Can you see?
Sure, sir.
Yeah, Professor Sahu, can you unmute and start your video if possible so that I can add you to the spotlight?
Well, there is a comment Hindi mein. Okay, we will try to keep it in Hindi also, RK.
Okay, if you will ask, English this is a standard protocol in my event that if you will ask the question in English, you will be finding your answers in English. Or in Hindi, you will ask. We will answer in Hindi. No issue. We are not the aliens. Don't worry.
Yes. Yeah. Dr. Sahu, can we have...
Sahu sir, aap kripya jo hai, mute karenge sir, please. Unmute dijiyega jara, please. Yeah. Agar aap meri awaaz sun rahe hain, please sir. Aur ab... Sahu sir is there?
He's there, but I don't know. Yeah. He's facing some technical...
Can you unmute them? Then you unmute.
I tried, sir, but it's not... like he has... I have asked him to unmute.
Before we begin, I would like to brief that Rakshak sir, जैसा कि मुझे EMRC से ही पता चला था कि ये जो project proposal था हमारा when we did applied for the MOOC proposal, online course के proposal के 2017 में I applied for that. You know, when it was approved and all that with the things, with the comments and all that, I got the proposals copy when we were starting the production. Then I came to know that because each and every step, it is peer review is there in evaluation. So I just at that time, I came to know that Professor Sahu was there who evaluated this project and this entire content with respect to their whatever the content's quality and all that. So we have got the blessings at the very first day of this industrial pharmacy project. So that's why I thought that he is the best person to bless us at this moment. So, right now he is serving in the DPSRU, that is Delhi Pharmaceutical Science Research University, as the director of Delhi Institute of Pharmaceutical Science and Research, Delhi Institute of Pharmaceutical Science and Research, DIPSAR it is called. So, I humbly invite you, sir, if you can hear me, please unmute. And we would like to hear you, sir.
I think there are technical difficulties.
Yeah, maybe. That's why.
Network issues.
Sir, correct me, Paren?
No.
Sir? So, sir, please, if you are listening, then whenever you are comfortable, please do let us know. And we will get back to you, sir. Sir, please. Right. Mukesh is following up with you, sir. Please.
Yeah, Dr. Rajan. We can invite our next expert comments from Mr. Vivek Hattangadi.
Vivek, sir.
Vivek, sir, can Welcome, we have sir. You? Yeah, Vivek, sir, you are on mute. But you're on mute, Vivek, sir. Please unmute.
Okay.
Just before inviting Vivek, sir, I would just in 30 seconds, I would tell you his work is exemplary, and I need not tell anyone what he has done for the industry. He is a perpetual learner, carries with him 46 years of learning experience in marketing and sales. He has been mentored by legends like late Professor Chita Mitra and late Professor Tarun Gupta. They are icons for the pharmaceutical industry in India. He is a proponent of good marketing practices in any industry. He started his career as a sales cum delivery boy and went on to be the vice president of an Indian transnational pharma company. He exists now to help the personnel in pharmaceutical industry to get proper learning and development opportunities. He has authored 6 books on pharma branding and marketing, and another one is in pipeline. He is also a guest faculty in many pharma business schools. So this is a very, very short introduction. If I go on, I will go on for an hour or so introducing the work of Vivek sir, but we do not have the time. Over to you, Vivek sir, for your expert's comment, any guidance for the students related to pharmacy.
First of all, my congratulations to Dr. Ajay Samalti. Launching three books at a time, that's amazing, that's awesome. And I haven't heard this before. Even Philip Kotler, I don't think, has released three books on one single day. This takes me back to 1998, when India launched, or rather tested, three nuclear bombs, one after another. That was a very momentous day, tumultuous day, 11th of, I think it was the 11th of May. And today, we are releasing three books at a time. And what makes me even more happier is that one of the books is in Hindi. We are known as the pharmacy of the world. Yet, even we at home, we are not given enough respect or attention to our national language. When we ourselves are not giving any importance to the national language, what to talk about the other countries? Today, there are 490 million Hindi-speaking people, which is almost equivalent to the population of, say, two-thirds of Europe. Yet, when you see the books being translated, it's been translated into Japanese, it's been translated into German, it's been translated into Spanish, into Chinese. But none of the prominent books have ever been translated into Hindi. And this is the fate of the pharmacy of the world. So it's my humble request to all of you sitting here, we should not neglect our mother tongue. It's the pride of our nation. I have one thing for the young pharmacists today, especially the ones who will be working a little later in F&D, formulations and development, or maybe research and development. I recently read a book by Philip Kotler called H2H Marketing, that is the genesis of human-centric marketing. And he writes in this book two or three very, very, very important things. It says, think of the end user first. The pharmacist, they should first think of the end user. And who are the end users? The patients. Keep the patients at the back of the mind and then start developing new products. And this trend is being followed in many, many countries, even the smallest of the countries, Singapore. When they develop drugs, they first keep the patients in mind. Patients should be kept in the forefront in any drug developmental programs. People think that drug development programs are very, very, very costly. But I would like to say it's really not. There are simple things which are human problems which can be looked after by the pharmacists when they come to developing new products. For example, take a very simple case of a small bottle of eye drops. How do you open the eye drops? First, you twist in the anti-clockwise direction to pierce a hole. And the amount of force which is required to twist and pierce a hole is tremendous. For people like you and me who are normal people, it's okay. But what about a patient of arthritis? What about a patient who is 70 years old or 80 years old? Will he have that kind of strength or stamina to open bottles with so much of pressure? These are the small things which pharmacists should look into. In fact, they should be hearing the voice of the patient. Yes, my friends, the young pharmacist, listen to the voice of the patients before you start any new enterprise or start developing a new drug. Today, why we are called the pharmacy of the world? The international market for the Indian products is more than almost 1.25 times the market for the domestic products. And in the coming years, the export is international, the export market is likely to, by 2030, it is likely to be five times more than the domestic market. And this is what we should try to be. For many, many, many years, I think almost for 20 years, we have been hearing that the India is the number third largest producing country of pharmaceutical products. But how many years we are going to remain at number three? Why can't we go to number one? Why can't we dream of number one or number two? This can happen when we invest in F&D. This can happen when we start thinking about the patient first and develop products, keeping the patient in the forefront. Start at the end. Start with the patient in the mind and see what are those F&D things which we can develop so that patients have a better outcome, better clinical outcome. Once again, my congratulations to Dr. Ajay Samaiti. Three books at a time, reminding me of the three nuclear bombs which were dropped on 11th May 1998. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vivek sir. Very rightly pointed out that we exist for the benefit of the humanity. Please think before doing anything about the patients for whom you are working, you are creating drugs. Whether in any department of pharmaceutical industry, you have to have the end in your mind, that is the patients. Doctors are dependent on you, remember, for this thing. So that's it. Coming from the veteran from a pharmaceutical industry, Mr. Vivek Hattangadi, I just can second the point, nothing else. Thank you, Vivek, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thanks a lot for your kind words and the motivating words. Hope we could visualize the end user, the need of the end user, and make ourselves capable enough to cater the need of the patients and the ultimately the end user of those medicines. And this is actually the purpose of serving the society indirectly, because the people who are serving the society in the healthcare sector, if they are not well versed with their nose and house and all the things, then I think it would be very difficult for us to maintain the harmony in the healthcare system. And this is why, and I assure you, sir, it won't work as a nuclear bomb. Don't worry. Only student. Because as far as the book writing is concerned, I think it's a very difficult task to write a book, because rather in the meantime, in the time required by writing, which one book writing requires, I think I can write a couple of dozens of research papers. It's rather easy to write a thing. So for last 1 year, I had given my publisher the last final draft of my all the books on the September 3rd, 2020. And this is the September, you can see the 25th. Then we would be able to launch the thing with all the works, revisions and all that. This is the only aim, that so that the learning may be a pleasant experience. It should not be like punishment. So that's why this is my aim to come up with the book. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Thank you, Vivek sir. And thank you, Dr. Ajay. I hope Dr. Sahu is connected now. Professor Sahu.
I think still there is some technical difficulty there.
Okay, so we move ahead with expert views from Dr. Rakshak Jain from EMRC, Roorkee. Dr. Rakshak.
Before Dr. Rakshak starts his expert comment, I would like to introduce him, that he's representing the complete team of Educational Multimedia Research Center, Roorkee, which is the center of Consortium for Educational Communication for producing the online course and all that. Whatever the projects are approved, these people give them the shape, you know, whatever the contents are there in the audio, video, visuals, the expertise by the EMRC. So we have invited the entire team. Due to some reasons, Director Sir is unable to attend, but Dr. Rajkumar Bharadwaj, first of all, I extend my thanks, humble thanks to Director Sir, and I'm happy that Dr. Rakshak is here to represent the EMRC on behalf of Director Sir. On behalf of the entire team of EMRC, each and everyone has been very instrumental in the development of online course, because these books are, you know, the extended project of these online course. If these online course won't have been there, I think these books might not have their existence. So we could have the courage to come up with this book just due to the people like Rakshak Jain sir, Shruti ma'am, Rama, Jatin, Pushpam, Anurag, Dilip, Mahesh, and Ali, and each and every staff member of Educational Multimedia Resource Center. So over to you, Jain sir.
Thank you very much, Dr. Samalti. And I am really thankful for appreciating our work. And Dr. Vivek rightly said that you are the powerhouse of energy. You have so much energy. I kept telling you before. So, and I am no pharmacy man, so I won't be able to tell much about this subject matter. But suddenly I am honored to be here before this August gathering on this occasion of book launch of Dr. Samalti, Dr. Ajay Samalti and Dr. Mona Samalti. I think it was jointly written by both the experts, correct? So I would like to congratulate Dr. Ajay and Dr. Mona for this new book. And I know it is going to be very helpful for the students of pharmacy. And I remember I first met him when he came to EMRC Roorkee for his move on industrial pharmacy. And I found him very energetic, dedicated towards his work. And I also observed that he is always actively working on new ideas. And I clearly remember how he came up with the creative idea of Jenny, a cartoon character in his move. That character shared these skills with Dr. Samalti and kept asking FAQs at different point of time. So that idea was really wonderful. And I wish all the best for all his future academic endeavors. And once again, I congratulate him for his book launch. I always used to tell him, sir, aapko yaad ho, main hamesha kehta hu aapko, ye kehta tha ki aapne na jaane kitni raatein kaali ki hongi, tab aapko ye ujiyara dekhne ko mila. So this is all basically because of your hard work. And hard work always paid. It should be paid. So kisi na kisi form mein aapko milega aur output hum sabke samne hai. We have seen three back-to-back book launch, I think. English mein tha, abhi Hindi mein aaya. So I am looking forward to seeing such more events of more book launches in the future, very near future. So thank you very much. I have with us my colleague, Shruti, and I think she wants to share her experience.
Please, Shruti ma'am, welcome. So Shruti ma'am is also the senior producer there in MRC Roorkee, and she has been our, you know, producer, director and all that, okay, in the entire journey. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, sir, for the welcome. I would like to congratulate Dr. Samalti, Dr. Mona Samalti and Dr. Ajay Samalti for the book launch. And I'm sure the book is going to be an asset for the pharmacy students. And I would like to, what I've seen about Dr. Samalti, your hard work and your constant academic efforts are really inspiring for all of us. So with that, once again, congratulations, Dr. Samalti, for the book launch. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
समय निकालने के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद और हम लोग सदैव आभारी हैं आपके हर एक स्टाफ मेंबर का। जो मैं आपके कुछ लोग जो नहीं जानते हैं जो कह रहे हैं कि हम प्रोडक्शन की बात कर रहे हैं तो आपको मैं बताना चाहूंगा कि ऑनलाइन कोर्स जिसको मैं थोड़ा ब्रीफ भी करूंगा दो एक मिनट में आपको बाद में, एक जो ऑनलाइन कोर्स जो स्वयं पे चल रहा है वो 2017 से हमें अप्रूव हुआ था, 2018 में हमने पूरा बनाया। तो जो बनाने के पीछे जो हमारी टीम थी उस टीम में जो है ईएमआरसी का एक महत्वपूर्ण योगदान है और उसके बिना वो संभव नहीं था। तो इन लोगों की वजह से देखिए पढ़ना पढ़ाना हमारा काम है, कैमरे के सामने क्या बोलना है कैसे बोलना है क्या करना है तो ये डंडा लेके हमारे सामने खड़े रहते थे कि ऐसे करना है ऐसे नहीं करना है। तो ये गुरु हमारे वहां के गुरु ये लोग हैं, तो हमें उसको प्रेजेंटेशन लायक बनाना, कैसे बनाना है क्या बनाना है वो हमने इनसे सीखा और इन्होंने हमसे करवाया। ठीक है, सो and it was a very wonderful journey of learning together to get a project in the form of an online course which has created a history itself in the pharmacy, because it is the first pehla aur ekmatra course hai swayam ke platform pe jo ki hamare emrc ke yogdan se bana hai। emrc nahi cec ke har ek sathi ka, chahe wo jitne bhi academic coordinators jo hai cec mein hamare baithe hain, चाहे दिशा है अर्चना है अर्चिता है रविंद्र है, I am always thankful to all of them because it is a coordinated efforts, it is a team effort which gives the result। जैसे कि आप देख रहे हैं तीन बुक, शायद किसी को लग रही होगी तीन बुक नहीं है, इसके पीछे की जो कहानी है वो चार पांच साल की जो रगड़ाई है वो मैं ही जानता है हम ही जानते हैं, यस इमारती वाले अच्छी तरह से जानते हैं कि तो हाँ ये है कि ये हिम्मत बन पाई कि हम एक साथ इसको ले पाए लेके आ पाए। आप लोगों की शुभकामनाओं के साथ धन्यवाद सर, धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू
डॉक्टर रक्षक एंड डॉक्टर श्रुति, रियली वंडरफुल वर्क डन बाय यू डायरेक्टिंग एंड प्रोड्यूसिंग द वर्क, ऑसम। लेट मी नाउ इनवाइट फॉर एन एड्रेस फ्रॉम मिस्टर अनिल शाह, MD, Pharma MedPress. Mr. Anil, can we hear you?
Yeah. Good evening. Yes,
welcome, sir. Anil, sir.
Good evening, sir. Good evening. Good evening to everyone on this World Pharmacies Day. And we, as you are already aware, we are associated with Samalti, sir, for almost close to 15 years now. And I think this is his fifth book. And as he said, we have some more in pipeline. And I would like to tell something about our Pharma MedPress group. See, we have been publishing books for the last 20 years. And besides the books written by Indian author, we have also taken rights from various different publisher authors, especially Dr. Sibaldi's book on pharmacokinetics is reprinted by us. And then we have Sarfaraz Niwazi also, we have taken rights and reprinted in India. Besides that, what we have done is there are a lot of foreign books which are prescribed in PCI and which are very useful for students and for teachers. So we have taken rights from the concerned publisher abroad and are selling those books at a lower price of around 1,000 to 1,500 rupees in the local India market, whereas the original will be costing around 8,000-10,000 rupees. So that is one thing which we are giving, we are contributing to the pharmacy for the betterment of the pharmacist and thereby and the educators or teachers. And now besides that also, we are publishing one journal, International Journal of Pharmaceutical Science and Nanotechnology, for the last 14 years. And recently it has been approved by the Scopus. And there are very few journals, especially from pharmacy, which have been accepted by Scopus, and we are also likely to get it approved by PubMed shortly. We've already done all the background work for that. We are hoping that we'll also be approved by early January or so. This is what we have been contributing. positive and we are looking forward. We are here to serve the pharma industry, and we are also official agents for Indian Pharmacopoeia, European Pharmacopoeia, and besides that, we have a strong industry orientation also. We publish a lot of books which are useful for pharma industry, especially on CGMP. We have a book, Quality Assurance and Quality Affairs. We have published a lot of books. So I congratulate Ajay sir, Mahanti, and the entire team. I have been hearing for almost half an hour about what efforts they have put. As a publisher, yes, even we have to spend a lot of time. It took almost 1 year, as Ajay sir told. Since the day he gave the manuscript to us to do all the page setting, then double checking, lot of it is not so easy to publish a book because lot of things have to be checked, double verified, and lot of things have to be done. So I hope that the entire pharma students community will receive the book and will get a good knowledge. We will be able to ask what is the purpose of the book, Dr. Ajay Samiti. What purpose Ajay Samiti has written the book? Reach the proper audience. One more thing I like to highlight here is that we have now converted all our books into e-books, and we are also now having global presence. So all of our books are available throughout the world. So we have tied up with some global partners in US. So this is what we are developing, and we are here to serve the pharma industry in future. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot for giving me the opportunity to speak.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anil sir. And it has been a great pleasure working with you and learning from you. I knew that the entire process of coming up with the quality projects takes the time. And I can understand that going through the changes, going through the revisions, it is utmost essential to come up with the things rather than going for the quick things, low quality things. It's very good that I'm very happy that you never compromise with the quality.
And we are now again, I would like to again add here that shortly we will release one more book. Maybe, I don't know how much time it will take, maybe another 1 month, I think. We will release the second book also. Hopefully, before end of December, we definitely will.
Great, Anil sir. Keep doing the good work that you have been doing for many years. And yeah, we hope to get a lot of good books from you.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
I must invite Mr. Naresh, the production manager from Pharma Metris, also to at least speak a few words. Mr. Naresh, are you there?
If Nikunj is there, Nikunj.
Mr. Naresh is there. Yeah. I'm asking him to unmute and be on the video.
The book is. The beauty about our publisher, Shahji might not have pointed out that the book is going to be available at the international level in each and every country. And the availability is ensured by the Book Syndicate publisher, and the Pharma Metris is the imprint of that. And we are very happy to be associated with the Pharma Metris for quite a long time. I think since 2007, I have the good association with the our publishing house, and in each and every nook and corner of the world, the book can be supplied and is being supplied, and even the e-book versions are going to be available. Kindle versions are going to be available, and very soon the book shall be available not only in the Amazon but also in the Amazon.com. And we have, the publisher has its own platform for purchasing the book. So we will be sending the links at the end of the event also. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay. Thank you for letting us know. All the questions will be taken up now. If Mr. Naresh is there, we can hear him. Or we can then move forward with the open discussion.
I don't think he's able to unmute, or there may be some technical glitch on his side.
Okay, no issue.
So I think we can move ahead.
So there will be an open discussion with Team Industrial Pharmacy. This is a question and answer session. We will also announce quiz winners. There was a lot of activity related to quiz, and more than 1,400 participants were there in the quiz. Thank you Thank you all of you for participating in the quiz and showing this response. Let us move within open discussion. Dear participants, please put up your questions.
Just to break the ice of the discussion. But I would like to say that, incubating our students for the industrial needs, we need to prepare the students who have got the practical knowledge. I was quoting in a particular lecture when we were having the live interaction with the our learners. Many of our learners are also here. That you study the X-ray diffraction, you study the SEM, but you have never seen the exact equipment and how sample is prepared. Without that, you will never have the insight of that. Many of our faculty members haven't seen the X-ray diffraction or whatever they are teaching. Say, for example, for the pre-formulation, they use some either X-ray diffraction, SEM, or whatever the equipment may be. Okay. But what the very first day we planned that we should have a good insight. Whatever is possible, we will try to record that thing and tell them the exact thing. Until I saw in a particular industry, what is the size of the actual fluidized bed dryer? What I was drawing in the 2D plain paper, the fluidized bed dryer, I thought that it would be like some sort of cylinder, all that. But when I saw the fluidized bed dryer in the pharma industry, the actual size, then I realized that what does it mean to the industry? What is the requirement? What is the actual value of that thing? That's why we must have a practical insight with respect to the topics of the industrial pharmacy. I would like to add this thing in our book. The chapters have been contributed by the Dr. Mona Simulty and Dr. Lokesh Adhikari. And we have come up with the 40 chapters there on almost each and every dosage form that is included in the syllabi. There after the pre-formulation, tablet, capsule, suspension, emulsion, parenterals, ophthalmics, palatization, and cosmetics, propellants, and tablet coating, their evaluation, regulatory guidelines, and each and everything, plus pharmaceutical packaging. So a 12-week online course was actually prepared, and then we went ahead with that thing. So what we know, that whatever you are preparing, just have this sound command over those topics and the basics. Need not to learn each and every specification, maybe, with respect to the industrial need, maybe. You must know the concept. But if the person is asked, if you are asked, what does the water test mean for the glass? Then you must know that, yes, it is the measure of checking out the leaching, that how much leaching is there, then we are adding the acid, and there's acid-based neutralization. And that you must know the basics, that what is the basis of that particular test, but that particular thing. It's a simple example I'm putting. And for the industry, it is utmost essential that actually the R&D is a very expensive job. The generic market, bioequivalent studies, dissolution studies, as Dr. Archana was mentioning, that yes, we must have a good knowledge about the regulatory guidelines, validation, GMPs. These are some of the key points which you must learn thoroughly before moving ahead to the industry, if you want to grow. Otherwise, obviously, you will learn there in the industry itself. But it's better if you're going for, especially after doing the PG and all that, you make yourself comfortable. I have started my journey from the sales and marketing. So I know that the marketing has got the different need, production has got the different need, regulatory, if you go for the DR, regulatory system, F&D or R&D, they have got the different requirements. But the basic must be cleared for each and every aspect. So this is the, in nutshell, I can say that what you should prepare for. Okay. Yeah. Please, if you have any query, please let me know, and then we can put it there. Before we go there, meanwhile, I will keep on checking the questions. I'm just going through to a particular presentation on a simple preparation which I have prepared with the for the book launch. We have a little bit time left, then we will. Yes, just few minutes you give me, so the people who are the principals, the faculty members who are there for the event, just come to know that what does the online course mean, which we have floated into the SWAM platform. Yeah, it's going to just hold on. Soon you will see the entire full screen maybe. Yeah. So welcome from Gadwal University. As you know, it's a central university near the bank of River Alaknanda in the lap of Himalayas on the midway to the Lord Badri Vishal. तो बाबा बद्री विशाल की कृपा और बाबा केदार की कृपा आप पर बनी रहे, माँ गंगा की कृपा बनी रहे। इसी आशा के साथ मैं आपको छोटा सा इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट आपको दिखा रहा हूँ कि इंडस्ट्रियल फार्मेसी स्वयं मूव्स और इंडस्ट्रियल फार्मेसी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का प्रोजेक्ट। इट इज द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ टेकिंग द एजुकेशन इन द डिजिटल फॉर्म इन द ऑनलाइन कोर्स फॉर्म दैट कैन बी यूज फॉर क्रेडिट ट्रांसफर, दैट कैन बी यूज फॉर CAS करियर एडवांसमेंट स्कीम, फॉर फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम। By doing these online program, आप online course कीजिए, अपना paper pass कर सकते हैं आप। Industrial pharmacy के बहुत सी universities are adopting, they have already adopted our course, especially the DY Patil, I would like to quote, maximum time in the each and every cycle, the toppers are from Dr. DY Patil Institute. I think Tanaji is there, Dilip Tanaji. He was one of the ranker in the very first cycle. I remember I just interacted with him. In the last cycle, in the last interaction in the DY Patil in an event. So explore reference SWAM. I request you, depending upon your needs, each and every set, even there might not be the complete syllabi, but the topic may be there. So you will get the video lectures, these reading materials, discussion forum, self-assessment quiz, each and every 4 quadrants you will get. So we present you the Pioneer MOOC in Pharmacy, that's the online course. I think this cycle, we are running the third cycle, and I think the next cycle is going to come in the January 2022. For that, enrollments are going to be starting in the November month. So for students, teachers, it is not like that, it's only for students. Teachers can get enrolled themselves. They can be mentored. They can use these materials for blended and flipped learning. Aap padhiye, padhaiye, bachcho ko bataiye cheezon ko. Things are available. So we present you this industrial pharmacy MOOC. This is my team. I'm proud to share my team, Dr. Mona Similti and Dr. Lokesh Adhikari from Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Gadwal University. So this cycle has already been started on 26th of July on this SWAM platform, and already the enrollment, we have got more than 4,500 plus enrollments we have got in the cycle, and put together 11,500 plus enrollments. With respect to the knowing about the dosage form, their tactical aspect of dosage form development, formulation evaluation, with respect to the syllabi. So we took this topic so that it's the first and last time you are learning these concept of dosage forms. As Dr. Rakshak was quoting, this is the character, Jenny, which is representing a learner. So I had an idea in my mind, because it might be a very boring topic when you are just keep on telling about the tablet coating or whatever the dosage form. So we created, just to create an interest in the undergrad level, we created a learner that she's moving, she's asking the question and putting her queries before us. And it's had been a wonderful experience. And the entire MRC team put their efforts for coming up with it. And it is a unique one in the entire MOOC. Only the IIM Bangalore I have got the inspiration also from the IIM Bangalore, Indian Institute of Management Bangalore. I discussed with professors there and got this thing. And Jitin has got from MRC has got a very vital role in designing this character, Jenny. So thank you, Jitin. And thank you, the entire team, MRC, for coming up with this Jenny, the learner, with us. We discussed. हमने बात किया कि भाई ये topic दिखता कैसे है, डिफ्यूजन एपरेटस से तो भाई चलता कैसे, काम कैसे करेंगे, कितना बड़ा है, कितना छोटा। एक्चुअली इट शुड बी शोन फर्स्ट टाइम फ्रायबिलिटी एपरेटस। मेरे लिए, मैं 10 साल से पढ़ा रहा हूँ, 18 साल से पढ़ा रहा हूँ, मेरे लिए नया ना हो, लेकिन वो बच्चा जो पहली बार पढ़ रहा है उसके लिए नया है, उसको ढंग से समझना आना चाहिए। For that, we have interacted directly in the course time to time. Unlike other courses, we time to time meet with our all the learners, that too in free live webinar sessions. Unit operations demos are there for the industrial part, which we have not got the chance for entering into the premises. We gave the animations there, eye-catching representation, and wonderful. You will see that it's one of the, I can surely say that it's one of the interceptor. I'm very happy to share that it has been listed in the Class Central list, very recently released in list, in the all-time favorite MOOCs, worldwide MOOC. We are there. So please join the course. And we have come up with these three books, Industry Pharmacy 1, Industry Pharmacy First, and Quick Review on Industry Pharmacy. This RX Expert series by the PharmaMed Press on this World Pharmacist Day 2021. So do join us. The links, we have our own open knowledge channel, and the links, we'll be sharing these links with you that we are doing the things. We have the courses on the various subject, NovaDW system, Sutics 1, cosmetics and pharmaceutical production technologies. I think in the mail, you will be getting these links also. And the Pharma State Academy, yes, the hosting agency with SWAM, cell of government of HNB Gadwal University. The Pharma State Academy has the various free courses, or some paid courses on various aspects of drug delivery and the pharmaceutical on the pharmacy education. You just join it and explore it and get the certificate. Some courses are also on the paid basis. Please do explore and prepare yourself for the industry, whether it is sales and marketing or in the industrial perspective. So do join us the courses on the our EdTech platform. Lastly, I would like to say that the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do. So kuch alag karne ke liye kuch alag mehnat bhi lagegi, wo karna hogi. Isi aasha ke saath मैं धन्यवाद करता हूं अपने मेंटर्स का, यूजीसी का, सीईसी का, ईएमआरसी रुड़की की पूरी टीम का, अपने विश्वविद्यालय परिवार का, वाइस चांसलर महोदय प्रोफेसर अन्नपूर्णा नौटियाल का, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का, और आप सभी प्रतिभागियों का कि आप हमारे साथ जुड़े और हमारे साथ हमारा जो है उत्साहवर्धन किया. थैंक यू, थैंक्स अ लॉट, एंड बैक टू यू. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू डॉक्टर अजय for taking us through this journey, because it is important. Why I am saying so, blended learning ka hi zamana hai. Videos mein aapko content mil raha hai, books ke saath bhi content mil raha hai. I don't know how lucky this generation is. They are getting it from both the sides, a blended sort of learning. It's the time when you can read offline, you can read online, you can read from n number of people, and you can learn from anyone who is ready to teach you. So we are blessed that Dr. Ajay Samelty has created courses also at our platform, at many platforms, and he has also written books. So do dive into this ocean of knowledge and get your base strong while you are entering this industry, or even if you are in the industry, you can go through the courses and read the books. Let us move towards the question and answers, Dr. Ajay.
Yeah, please.
Price of books, they are not very costly, Mr. Nikhil. You will be getting the this information.
We'll be sharing the links and you will come to, I think it's 725, 625, like that. Three books have got three different pricing. So we'll be sharing the links and for the direct purchase you can have. And obviously, from our side or from the publisher side, the 15% discount is going to be offered for a few days for the launch event. We'll be sharing the link, don't worry. But I think from the back end, Satish ji, please do remember to share the links the purchase links.
Dr. Ajay, will there be an e-version also? People have asked.
Yeah, obviously. I think our team, publishing team, has already answered that thing. E-versions are also available, and in a few days it will be available. The Kindle versions, we are coming, and the e-versions are also available. And obviously they will be more cost effectively. As compared to that print books.
Sure. Thank you, Dr. Ajay. Please put in your questions, participants, related to this. Otherwise, there are a lot of comments and compliments. Congratulations, Dr. Ajay, Dr.
Thank
Mona.
You
both are such an inspiration for the Pharma Society. And I'm literally blessed that I'm your student from Ms. Usma
As far as the online course are different, it is not just pharmacy. From the SWAYAM platform and number of courses, each and every subject is there available. Even biotechnology, biochemistry will be there, but it may not be pure pharmaceutical biochemistry, but yes, it will be there. So you can learn the thing. You will have to explore what is relevant to you, and then you can grasp the thing. I myself, at a time, I'm enrolled in more than 12 courses just to explore that what is there, how I can give those content, those things to my students, extend those things to my students. You will have to pick the things, and you just share the quality material to your students, rather than going through just a book which has been written 20 years back or 25 years back. Just take the quality content, updated content from the experts.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay. There was a question at the start and which I find very relevant coming from Mr. Shivam. Thank you, sir. How to start studying pharmacy from basic, because there's very big gap in academia and industry. How to fill that, being a student of third year? We know very, very less about industry working. How to fill this?
First of all, if you want to learn framing the sentences, you will have to learn the ABC. Alphabet. This book is the ABC of the thing. You are the, for the very first time, you have come to know about the tablet in first semester when you learned about the dispensing. You learned about the definition. Now, this is the time you will have to learn how it is prepared, how it is formulated, what are the excipients, the definitions of the various things, what is the difference between the lubricant, what a glidant, whatever. First, you will have to focus. You should focus learning the basic concept of thing. I'm telling basic concept. If you will just read this book or read the things or go through the things just for sake of passing the papers, you will lose the actual essence of the book. If you want to go to the industrial perspective, you must have a practical orientation towards the grasping that particular knowledge. So just learn. आपको सीखना है इस तरह से कि सीखने के लिए सीखना है, पास करने के लिए नहीं सीखना है. बात हमेशा मैं अपने बच्चों को भी बोलता हूँ, स्टूडेंट को भी बोलता हूँ, आपका जानना ये जरूरी है. Nobody asks percentage from you. किसी MD को पूछा है क्या तुम्हारा कितना परसेंट आया था? वो अपनी कुव्वत के बदौलत, वो अपनी लर्निंग की बदौलत वहां पर है. जो उसने सीखा है और जो उसने प्रैक्टिस किया, दैट इज अटमोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट, विच यू कैन प्रैक्टिस. इफ यू डोंट नो एनीथिंग, हाउ यू विल प्रैक्टिस? एंड द प्रैक्टिसिंग इट इन द मोस्ट एफिशिएंट वे इज डिजायर्ड बाय द इंडस्ट्री. दैट यू कैन डू ओनली व्हेन यू विल लर्न द ABC. यू डोंट नो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द बाइंडर एंड डिसइंटीग्रेंट, देन हाउ कैन यू बी प्रेटी श्योर टू फॉर्मुलेट ए पर्टिकुलर टैबलेट और द थिंग? तो प्रैक्टिकल, आपको प्रैक्टिकली उस चीज को सीखना है. लैब में जाइए, उस चीज को देखिए, समझिए. ये समझने का समय है और पहली और अंतिम मौका है आपको उस चीज को समझने का. उसके बाद एमफॉर्म में जब आप आएंगे तो आपको कहेंगे क्यों उस साल नहीं पढ़ा था, फोर्थ ईयर में आते ही बोलेंगे क्यों वहां पढ़ लिया होगा तुमने तो थर्ड. तो वो गया, ये चीज अगर निकल गई तो आगे कोई नहीं समझाने वाला. आज है और अभी समय है सीखने का, उसके बाद वो मौका भी नहीं मिलेगा. उसके बाद आपके पास ये भी नहीं रहेगा कि आप किस मुंह से पूछने जाएंगे. एमकॉम का स्टूडेंट घबराता है पूछने में कि सर ये टैबलेट का ये बेसिक कैलकुलेशन कैसे होगा, क्योंकि उसे तो वहां सीखना था ना. तो दिस इज द हाई टाइम, प्रिपेयर यूर सेल्फ विद द बेसिक्स. एंड ऑब्वियसली आई वॉज टेलिंग माई एल्डर सन दैट यू विल हैव टू कीप ऑन रोलिंग द थिंग्स. धक्का मारना होता है, मारते रहना पड़े, उसके बाद चीजों को आप छोड़ते नहीं. यू कीप ऑन पुटिंग योर एफर्ट्स, then they start first time to roll, then they accelerate until you stop the things. You are not expected to stop. आपको अपने प्रयास रोकने नहीं है, तभी चीजें भागेंगी, तभी चीजें उस तरह से विजुलाइज हो पाएंगी जैसे विवेक सर कह रहे थे कि विजुलाइज करना. यस, यू हैव टू विजुलाइज सक्सेस. स्टीफन कोवे 7 Habits में कहते हैं आपको विजुलाइज करना पड़ेगा. आप 6 साल बाद 7 साल बाद अपने कहां देखना चाहते हो बीफार्म करने के बाद? प्रोडक्शन के पैकेजिंग सेक्शन में किसी डब्बे को बंद करते हुए पाया जाना चाहते हो, या कि वीपी के या उसमें तौर पे देखना जाना चाहते हो, ये आप पे डिपेंड करता है. उस सक्सेस को विजुलाइज करना और उसके लिए मेहनत करना. हर चीज में मेहनत लगती है, कुछ ना कुछ कॉस्ट होती है हर एक चीज की. समटाइम्स इट टेंजिबल, समटाइम्स इट इंटेंजिबल. फिलहाल तो इतना ही है कि ये टेंजिबल चीज है, इसको पढ़िए और आए कीजिए, श्योर यू विल गेट द सक्सेस. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू डॉक्टर अजयन. एंड शिवम, थर्ड ईयर इज नॉट वेरी लेट, यू हैव स्टिल अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम. अगर आप यही सवाल आफ्टर पासिंग आउट करेंगे देन यू विल हैव टू वर्क ट्वाइस और थ्राइस हार्ड. So please,
yeah, it is appreciable, Shivam, that you are worried for that. But
yes,
it is more important that you convert your worries into the efforts. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Shivam. Okay. When will you start a MOOC course on Industrial Pharmacy 2 on Swayam? Okay.
Yeah, obviously, I want to start today itself, but it is on the government because without funds, it is not possible to create this thing. Without the facilities like EMRC, it is not possible for that. Very soon, we will come up with the courses, and we are working rather in some edtech platform, at least in the pharma state. We are coming with the new things, newer things quite frequently. But for a national platform, we need the fundings, obviously. It takes time and takes money. It takes effort to come up with the course. Some of our courses are already approved, but we are just awaiting the confirmation of that grants from the ministry. Soon, we will be coming up with some new courses. Goodbye.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay. There are a request rather. Please design a course for research and development basics.
I think research and development as such, as far as the research publication related, I think you might be knowing, I'm also running another course on academic writing, for which the book has already been released on 14th of August. That is related to the research. With respect to pharmaceutical research, I'm also going to come up with the book, which is in the final stage and almost it is published, Art of Writing, which includes pharmaceutical research, that executing the pharmaceutical research in the actual domain. With respect to the academic research, I have written that, and with Dr. Mona Semelty. So I have co-authored the book, and the book is also being published. Just to avoid the confusion, I didn't mention that book. And it is the extension project of our book, which the first edition which was released on 2007. So it is a completely new book now, and it will be published soon. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay. There are no more questions. One question from Urvi. I am BSc chemistry student and now doing MSc chemistry. But I am interested in pharmaceutical industry. So is there any scope? A lot of scope,
Urvi? Yeah, obviously. As you were saying, our chief mentor, industry expert, is from chemistry itself, completely. She has done her PhD there, postdoc there, from PhD, and wonderful people. They have huge scope for chemistry. But if better, we focus on the aspects. Chemistry is a very huge subject, but the aspect which is very relevant to the and very important to the pharmaceutical industry, say, for example, knowing about the impurities, identifying the impurities, level of impurities, polymorphism, I was telling that. Racemization, these concepts which are pre-formulation, just to go through the book, I think it is very suitable for you also. That I have also for my target reader, the student of the chemistry are also there. Because if you go through the book, I think you will find it quite easier to learn the things and for getting the entry into the pharma R&Ds. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay, and thank you, participants, for asking the questions. I think it's the quiz time now. That means not exactly the quiz time. You all participated in quiz, but thank you for awesome participation. Overwhelming response to this quiz. We got 1,400 plus participants who participated in the quiz. And in this on this occasion of World Pharmacist Day, you will be given the prize. Top 5 winners will get the hard copy of Industrial Pharmacy 1 book. So the winners are rank 1, Poonam Deshmukh, rank 2, Unnati Petse, rank 3, Dhananjay Patil, rank 4, Sahil Prakash, and rank 5 to Garvita Sharma. Congratulations to the winners. You will be getting your copy of the book soon. And thank you for participating. Keep participating in the quiz and keep learning. We will really appreciate your enthusiasm.
Thank you. Congratulations to all the winners. I humbly extend my congratulations. And I'm also thankful to all the faculty members, specifically before going to the vote of thanks. especially the, all the principals, the life members of APT and IP who are present here. They spared their valuable time and shared the event, shared the information to their students. It was very vital support from our faculty members. And thank you. Thanks a lot. Over to you, Swati.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay. You are quite a motivator. Also, we have heard you and we really look forward to hearing you. A session on motivation also, Dr. Ajay, because that is lacking. So we will like to invite you on a session on motivation. Let us move to the vote of thanks. This will be done by Dr. Mona Similti. Welcome, Mona, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you, Swati, for giving me opportunity to thank everybody present in this event today. Well, Swati, today is World Pharmacy Day. So first of all, I congratulate all of us for World Pharmacy Day. And today's day is also very important, for especially for Team Industrial Pharmacy, the launch day of our three books, Industrial Pharmacy Quick Review, Industrial Pharmacy English version and Hindi version. And especially I'm very excited with the launch of book in Hindi version, because when today and yesterday I was sharing the information about this event to all the participants and all the learners, I got lot many queries regarding the Hindi version, especially because this is the first of its own kind book at undergraduate level, Industrial Pharmacy 1 Hindi version. So I'm quickly reading out the acknowledgement to thank everyone who supported us in completion of this task. So I would like to thank all the persons who helped in designing, planning, and finishing this book. Firstly, I would like to thank my family members for their continued encouragement, support, and assistance. Without them, it would have not been possible to complete the book. As John Cotton Dana said, who dares to teach must never cease to learn. So this is the teacher who is solely responsible for quality of teaching and learning process. In the process of learning and teaching, we also learn a lot many things about likes and dislikes of the students regarding the choice of books and reading habits. So I have tried to focus my efforts on those points to make the book student friendly. I'm very thankful to our students whose input again helped in designing and planning of this book. The learning is a never-ending process that will positively enhance our awareness and knowledge and will positively contribute to our abilities as teachers. So I'm very thankful to all the respected teachers who read, refer, and recommend this book to their students. I warmly acknowledge the contribution of, this is for myself, Dr. Mona Similti. So thank you, Dr. Ajay, for acknowledging me. Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, HNB Garhwal University, a Central University, Srinagar Garhwal, and Mr. Lokesh Adhikari, Senior Project Associate, UGC-DAE CSR Project, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, and their vital contribution. I humbly acknowledge Ministry of Education, especially Government Ministry of Education, especially Government of India, Swayam National Coordinator, CC New Delhi, Professor J.B. Nadda, Director CEC Engineer Nageshwar Nath, Joint Director CEC Dr. Rajkumar Bhardwaj, Director EMRC Roorkee, and the team EMRC Roorkee for providing grant and vital support in development of Industrial Pharmacy online course. So from EMRC Roorkee, Dr. Rakshak were with us in the event today. We heard Dr. Rakshak few minutes before. So I also thank Professor B. Suresh, President, Pharmacy Council of India, Professor P.K. Sahu, Director, Research, DPSI University, New Delhi. So P.K. Sahu, sir, he had some network issues, so he's not able to connect with us today. Thank you so much, Professor Sahu, sir, for your constant encouragement and support. Professor H.S. Professor S.H. Ansari, Faculty of Pharmacy, Hamdard University, New Delhi, Professor Pavan Kumar Dubey, Director, Vivekanand College of Pharmacy, Indore, Professor Munish Ahuja, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar, late Professor Y.S. Thawar, B.N. College of Pharmacy, B.N. University, Udaipur, Rajasthan, Professor Vandana Panda, K.M. Kunnani College of Pharmacy, Professor N.S. Hari Narayana Murthy, Dean Pharmacy, Indira Gandhi National Tribal University, Amarkantak, and all other well-wishers who always keep triggering me time to time for the work like this. I am very thankful to my project associate, Mr. Mukesh Pandey, and Himanshu Mishra, and all the staff members of Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences. I also extend my gratitude to the entire university family of H.N. Bigarwal University. I humbly acknowledge the team of BS Publication, Mr. Anil Shah, and his entire publishing team, Pharma Med Press, Hyderabad, India, with special thanks to Mr. Naresh Devergave for his entire production team, for their efforts, guidance, and timely support in preparation of this. So I am always indebted to my guru, Professor M.S. Imrawat, former Vice Chancellor and currently working as advisor, Department of Higher Education, Government of Uttarakhand, and Professor Annapurna Nautiyal, Honorable Vice Chancellor, H.N. Bigarwal University, for their continuous support and blessings. Last but not the least, I thank my mother, late Mrs. Lakshmi Semalti, and God Almighty for giving strength, patience, and determination to complete this work on time in present form. So I also thank the team CEC. Special thanks to Disha, Asmita, Archana, Arshia, Ravindra from the entire team of EMRC, UGC Joint Director, Dr. Gopu Kumar, Deputy Secretary, Dr. Deeksha Rajput, Mr. Abhishek Kumar, Project Officer, and the entire Swayam backend team. And from Ministry of Education, special thanks goes to Mr. Ajay Singh for his continuous support. So, and lastly, I thank each and every person who helped us and motivated us in completing these books. So congratulations to all of you on the World Pharmacist Day once again. And thank you so much to your participants, and congratulations to all of you once again. So that's all, Swati. So
thank you. I would like to add the faculty members and principals of various and directors of various institutes who have joined us and shared the event. And thank you, Dr. Archana ma'am. It was a very first interaction, and I think we will be having more events and the opportunities to hear you and get the vital things from you, and to establish an academic and industrial that bridge, to make that bridge. I think we would like to have your vital help. Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot for accepting our invitation and giving your valuable time. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Or Vivek sir, aapka bhi bahut bahut sir se dhanyawad. We would love to have you here with us, with our students itself. Or Dr. Archana, मैंने पहले भी बात किया था, कुछ बीच में हम बात भी नहीं कर पाए. हम चाह भी रहे थे कि कुछ ऐसा हो कि बच्चे को कहते ना, पढ़ते पढ़ते वो घबरा जाता है किताबें देख देख के. तो मकसद ये है कि उसकी घबराहट निकाल दी जाए बस. बाकी तो वो कर लेगा, कह रहा तैर तो वो जाएगा, वो घबराहट निकालनी जरूरी होती है. तो मकसद हमारा वही है, चीजों का ऑलवेज कोट दैट इट इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट टू मेक द थिंग्स सिंपल एंड टू ब्रिंग अबाउट सिंप्लिसिटी इन लाइफ. आई थिंक इट इज द मोस्ट कॉम्प्लेक्स थिंग. दिस इज द एगोनी ऑफ द लाइफ एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू दैट. सो आई थिंक वी विल बी गेटिंग दिस हेल्प फ्रॉम यू पीपल एज अ मेंटर. एंड अगेन very thankful, and Professor Sahu, I'm very thankful to you for your vital time. Sorry we could not hear you due to some connectivity issue maybe. And thank you with respect to the entire team, obviously the publishing team and the Pharma State. I always, though you are the host, but I think at this time I would like to thank you people for helping us, especially Dr. Satish from the back end, and Dr. Swati, my right hand Dr. Lokesh, my other project associate, Mr. Mukesh Pandey. Thank you. आशा करते हैं हम इसी तरह मिलते रहेंगे और कुछ नया करते रहेंगे. धन्यवाद.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ajay. Thank you, Dr. Archana. Thank you, Vivek.
और आपको जो purchase की link है, जो link जो आपका कई participant कह रहे थे, वो आपको mail के साथ अभी भी जो है शायद सतीश जी ने की होंगी, तो कुछ देर हम रुक के आप रुके और वहां पर जो है आपको लिंक भी वहां पर मिल जाएगी और वैसे मेल के साथ भी हर एक को भेज जाएगी. धन्यवाद. धन्यवाद मैम. धन्यवाद सर.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay. Thank you, Dr. Moona. And thank you, Dr. Lokesh. We are learning from you three a lot. And you all keep guiding us. And Vivek sir is always there with us. Thank you, sir. And Dr. Archana, we look forward to hosting you on some session. Your knowledge, we would love to share through our platform, Pharma State Academy, and would invite you personally to join us. Thank you, ma'am. And thank you, all the participants. You are awesome. You people have been really, sticking to this event and learning. Thank you for participating, asking questions. We look forward to hosting more and more sessions with you. Bye for now.
Thank you very much.
Satish, acha Swati, tumhe jana hoga
fir se event. Yeah.
Right. Thank you.
We are ending the session now.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Swati. Bye.